First, Prashant and Ronodeep, I'd like to sort of set the ball rolling by just give me how you distinguish between brand and performance marketing.
So, you know, today we're in an age where the lines are pretty blurred here. You know, 15 years ago where, you know, brand pretty much meant TV, radio, there wasn't much performance marketing happening. It was like a brand campaign, right? So you could kind of segregate that very clearly. Today, whenever we are doing a brand campaign, when we're going live with a video, when we're going live with social media ads, there are components of performance marketing that are associated with it, right? Like how many views did I get? How many click-throughs did I get? So at the end, you know, all brand campaigns now pretty much fit or segue into performance marketing KPIs. And, you know, we personally at Adlift, we've actually seen that coming where, you know, for the last 6, 12, 18 months, we've always been asked when we're introducing ourselves, are you a performance marketing agency or are you a brand agency? And to us, I think it's one and the same thing, right? Because if I am running a performance marketing campaign, core KPI is obviously sales and leads. But at the end of the day, I want my brand searches to go up. I want people to know me while I actually run performance. At the same time, when I'm doing a brand campaign, it segues into your performance marketing. Mm-hmm. And that's why we have, you know, we made tremendous changes within the org to come across as both a brand creative organization as well as performance marketing with Rono, you know, 17 plus years of his experience within the creative side to really head that. So today, we kind of are eating our own dog food where we're saying both brand as well as performance marketing are one and the same thing.
Okay. Ronodeep, do you have anything to add?
Just to add to Prashant, you know, there are certain categories of advertisers and brands, like we work on a couple of these accounts ourselves, that is completely, the performance side is completely led by brand creatives, like educational institutes, you know, fintech products, you know. It's all about creating that perception, telling you, dumbing down all the attributes of the brand, what they stand for, etc. And then calling out for, you know, your enrollments, your app downloads, whatever. So it's very, the scene is very hand-to-hand brand and performance for these kind of categories.
Okay, so from what you're saying, I understand that there's scope for the two to coexist and complement each other.
Absolutely. I mean, if you're not doing that, then you're doing something wrong. We're in the digital space, you know, we spend 3x more time on online versus on TV. Right, we're spending 3.5 hours on average on social media platforms. We're spending 7 hours across digital. We're at about 600 million, you know, internet users, second to only China. So when we're actually looking at all these numbers, which have both a connotation across brand as well as performance, they have to coincide with each other. So I don't see it any other way.
Okay, Ronodeep, I'd like to ask you is. How do you choose performance marketing over brand marketing?
Brand marketing is very clear. It kind of sets the tone for who the brand is, what the personality of that brand is. It's more for awareness. Unless you create that awareness, performance doesn't tick. Okay, so you got to first create that awareness through your brand marketing, and then performance dovetails into that whole process and kind of gives you that traction for the brand.
Okay, fair enough. So then we come to, is there a wrong time or wrong way of performance marketing? Is there a time when you don't choose performance marketing?
No, so I think, you know, performance marketing is always on, right? So performance marketing, the way we kind of break it down into, you know, different verticals, you've got search, right, which is Google search partners platform. You've got organic SEO, which is organic search. You've got paid social, organic social, right? So there are 4 to 5 very core digital performance channels. SEO, for one instance, why I say, you know, things should be always on, is not something that you can switch on, you know, the day before. You need to drive traffic, visits, you know, conversions. It's something that has to be sustainable, and you have to have a plan to execute that across time. Content marketing, right? Tomorrow, if you're like launching a new product or you want to actually increase sales, it's not something that you do for 1 month and then forget about it, right? So performance marketing has to be always on if you really want to drive your core KPIs. There are instances, right, where seasonality kicks in. So suppose I'm in the education space, I'm not going to start, you know, spending more right after all the admissions are closed. Right, so that's where you kind of taper it down or close it. So seasonality, depending on certain businesses like Diwali and electronics and consumer products, is huge. So you can kind of really bolster up spends on performance marketing and maybe taper it down immediately. So it kind of, it has its ups and downs, but performance is always on.
Mm-hmm. Ronadeep, from a creative standpoint, is there any distinction for when not to use performance marketing, when actually brand marketing makes more sense?
At the time of launching certain ideas, IPs, products, services, obviously brand marketing kind of sets the tone right for those products and services. Once you create that aura for your brand, that what you're supposed to be known for, and depending on the category or the product or the brand, then performance will kick in, because performance is all traction-oriented matrix. So depends. Like, you know, you might, like as an advertiser, as a consumer, I might see a hoarding and I buy a TV, but as the advertiser, he might not know that because of that hoarding, I bought the TV. Whereas when I see that ad on internet and I click through it and I buy that TV on Amazon or something, then that metric is in place.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, you know, I'll add to this, right? And there's ton of data that we've seen internally at Adlift Research, where we've kind of mined performance only brands and performance plus brand-led campaigns, and performance plus brand always has higher ROAS. Like, that's pretty much a given. And you know, the metrics feed into each other, right? So if I've actually done a big brand awareness campaign, I do start to market or remarket to folks who've actually viewed that ad for more than 3 seconds or 6 seconds. Today, platforms enable us to do that, right? So leverage a brand awareness campaign to really drive performance. Again, if I don't know a certain brand, I'm not going to, the propensity for me to actually buy that product is way less, right? My conversion rates would dip, which again segues into performance marketing. So branding is something that should definitely be in the mix, because it feeds into your performance marketing metrics and it should not be treated separately.
Okay. And lastly, you know, we just had a very interesting session on influencer marketing, and begs to ask whether or where influencer marketing then sits. Does it sit with brand marketing or does it sit with performance marketing?
Okay. You want to take that?
In my books, influencer marketing is basically the digital version of celebrity endorsement. Okay, okay. And it's like Prashant puts it, you know, there's zillions of celebrities on digital as opposed to mainline, and that's, I mean, influencer marketing is as simple as that. I mean, we get it's like somebody telling you this is better than the other in your own tone, in your own world. And we are consumed with internet and all these channels, etc. If somebody that I kind of relate with is therefore then telling me, you know, I wear these shoes for my jogging, I get more easily convinced, as opposed to a Shah Rukh Khan telling me I jog in these shoes.
Yeah, and you know, I think currently it fits within the brand side, because you know, metrics across influencer marketing are hard to track, right? You heard a lot of the influencers here. My very dear friend who we work with, Sumer, across multiple influencer marketing campaigns, he actually loves it, right? That there's not a lot of trackability. But when, you know, you're talking from an agency or a performance marketing brand-led agency perspective, there are metrics that the brand would, you know, hold you against, which currently are all over the place, right? So tracking based on an influencer marketing campaign is tough. It's currently, I think, it's very, very widely spread. Like there's no, you know, one. So when you're actually selling a service or you're selling a commodity, commodities that do well have standardized pricing, right? That's how it peaks. Now, if we even look at the likes of Facebook and Google, these advertising platforms made it really use, because they had standardized pricing, right? Yes, CPCs did increase for certain verticals and they quarter over quarter, but pretty much it was a ballpark. Whereas with influencer marketing today, it's all over the place, right? So for influencer marketing to start moving towards performance, I do envision a platform coming into play. Maybe this is Instagram turning something on their end where they actually have all of the data. Today we see maximum influencer marketing campaigns being led on Instagram. So I do envision that to happen probably at some point to make influencer marketing sit more on the performance as opposed to brand.
Okay.